Hi guys, buona Pasqua, happy Easter. As you can tell, today's topic is Easter, which is Pasqua in Italian. And for this occasion, I have a rabbit on my shirt, which is not just a rabbit. If you know him, I respect you. If you don't, you should. Anyway, moving on. The main celebration is, as you know already, probably is on Sunday, which is Pasqua. The next day is Pasqu&Pasquetta, so like little Pasqua, little Easter. On the Sunday before Pasqua, before Easter, you get l'ulivo, which is this thing here. And yeah, when you go to the church, or you can even just buy it, and it's a symbol of like peace. Also because that's the first thing that the dove from Noé brought him when he was on the ship, if you know a bit of the Bible. But the main thing that we have for Easter are eggs, as you can tell. Chocolate eggs, of course, with a little surprise inside. We will open it together. And other things are, this one is like, okay, usually it comes with this thing here, but I took it off already because otherwise you couldn't see because of reflection. And yeah, that's something that people give as a present or just buy for the family. It's like kind of Christmas again, but with spring. So we have la colomba. Colomba means dove, and in fact you can see that the shape is the one of the bird. And inside has the same things of panettone, if you remember that, canditi. So you can guess that I don't like it. But it comes in different types and flavors. You can find it with chocolate, alcohol, or whatever you like, basically. Yeah, so this is la colomba. We can open it together. Yeah, it's a lot smaller than the box, of course. And there's sugar on top, so it really reminds me of panettone. It's called ovetti because uovo is egg, uova di cioccolato is eggs of chocolate. Be careful with this word in Italian, the singular is uovo, but the plural is uova. Yeah, like dito, for example, it's not diti, but it's dita, and that's because it comes from Latin, so that's why. Just remember that uovo is not uovi, but uova. That's the first thing that shows if you're not a native speaker, probably. So, because it's irregular, it's not uovetti, but it becomes ovetti, which means little eggs, small eggs. Cioccolato al latte is like milk chocolate, and cioccolato fondente is dark chocolate, which is my favorite. Let's go to the main part and open chocolate egg. It says cioccolato fondente, so dark chocolate, con sorpresa, so with surprise. Sorpresa is surprise. I used to get a lot of them when I was a kid. No, I don't, but my mom still bought some. And it comes with this thing here. There's chocolate under surprise. I should eat that. Let's see what it is. That's the thing. Oh, I see. It's like a small car. There are themed eggs, chocolate eggs, so you can choose like the cartoon that you like or your favorite football team, so you get a gadget of that. The smell of chocolate is the best. Let me put it aside for a moment. The one that I showed you is from a supermarket, but there are also shops that make eggs themselves, and you can even customize that. So you can choose what to put inside. Some are so big and so decorated that it's such a shame to eat them. We usually spend Easter, which is on Sunday, with relatives to eat, stay together, play games maybe. But Monday, which is Pasqu&Pasquetta, is usually spent with friends. I mean, that's not the rule. It's just what I used to do and what my friends do as well, because otherwise I wouldn't have friends to spend Pasqu&Pasquetta with, right? So it kind of makes sense. The main part is barbecue, because it's spring, it's sunny, I hope, and people just want to stay outside, so we barbecue. Speaking of some useful words, as I told you, there's colomba, uovo, sorpresa, rabbit is coniglio, peace is pace, barbecue we also call it grigliata, and then we say buona Pasqua, so a happy Easter, buone feste, happy holidays. I can't really think about something specific for Pasqua, so for Easter, because it's still a holiday, so we say the same thing, so let's just read that together. It says, la festa da vivere secondo tradizione. La festa, festa is holiday. Da vivere is to live, to spend. Secondo la tradizione, according to tradition. For example, I can say, secondo me è molto buono. In my opinion, it's really good. So secondo, even if it just means second, in like when you're counting primo, secondo, first, second, when you put it before a noun, according to that noun. For example, secondo Daisy, so Daisy's opinion, secondo mia madre, in my mother's opinion, and blah, 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 and so on. I think the best Italian lesson for this video will be listening and comprehension of these. E così siamo tutte. C'è anche Fra. Siamo in coda, che bello. Come si chiama in italiano?
Casello.
Casello. Tolls.
Tolls.
Solo monete, però non è self-service. Only coins, solo vabbè. Monete.
1,40 euro.
Dice arrivederci. Arrivederci. When someone can't wait to get into the nature. Dici come sta andando il fuoco?
Sta andando bene, molto bene.
Ragazzi, vi avanzate.
Questo se lo butto sopra così cade.
Cioè, sì, 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 sì.
Più tanto quello è già così.
Un altro giro?
Anyway, I hope you spent a happy holiday and that I showed you something interesting. See you soon. Thanks for watching. Okay, let's open the other one as well. By the way, if you're wondering, this one is 250 grams. Oh no. Oh, it's a necklace.